Hello students, I am Dr. Aruna Mohan from Delhi University, and today I will discuss with you reproductive system in humans. I am sure you remember in the previous session I discussed asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. In humans we have sexual reproduction, hence male reproductive system and female reproductive system we have to understand separately. Also, we know that in humans there is sexual dimorphism. That means just by looking at the external features, we can make out whether it is a male or a female. I now start with details of male reproductive system. In the male or in man, there is a pair of testes. There are two testes which are present in the scrotum. Scrotum is extension of abdominal cavity, or in other words I can say that testes are not present in abdomen, they are present outside the abdomen. There is a reason for this. For spermatogenesis to occur, for sperms to form in the testes, it is required the temperature of testes should be few degrees lower than the body temperature. And that is the reason it is found outside the abdominal cavity in a sac-like structure called scrotum. You can see in the diagram, the testis, which is a very delicate tissue, it is also called main sex organ for men. All other associated organs are called accessory reproductive organs. In each testis, there are compartments, and in the compartments there are seminiferous tubules. Seminiferous tubules are the seat for the formation of sperms, the details we are going to take little later. If we go for the structural part or anatomical part of reproductive system, from seminiferous tubules start vas efferens through rete testis, and these vas efferens will end on to epididymis. Please remember, epididymis is also located inside the scrotum. The sperms are formed in testis but are stored in epididymis. We can also understand it in a little different way. The sperms which are in the testis cannot fertilize the ovum because they are immature and aging has not taken place, the growth has not taken place. They will go to epididymis, they will be stored there for varying periods, and then the aging and the growth will take place, and now sperm is ready for fertilization. Going back to vas efferens will come out from testis through rete testis and will continue as epididymis or will end on epididymis. You can see in this diagram on the left side the epididymis. Epididymis has three parts: cauda, caput and corpus. It does the work of storing the sperms. And now from epididymis begins vas deferens. Also, please remember, all this is happening in the scrotum. We are still outside the abdominal cavity. Now, this vas deferens which emerges from epididymis, now it ascends to the abdomen or abdominal cavity and goes inside and will meet its counterpart, that is other vas deferens behind the urinary bladder, which you can see on the left diagram. The reddish color is the urinary bladder, and two vas deferens are meeting there. The moment they meet each other, they lose independent existence and they continue now in the form of urethra. Many more things happen at this point. Urethra will receive secretions from accessory sex gland called seminal vesicles. You can see leaf like seminal vesicle at the point where vas differences are joining each other. This secretion is very important, nutritive and supportive. Urethra through which sperms will move in the fluid secreted by seminal vesicles, as I have already told, there are prostate glands. Secretion from prostate gland will also come, and then there is bulbourethral gland which will join urethra towards the end. And bulbourethral gland will give out the secretion which provides lubrication. Now, if we try to understand, you can see on the diagram now, you can see testis, also epididymis, then vas difference taking root to abdomen. You can see leaf like seminal vesicles and you can see urethra. Now, this urethra continues through penis. Penis is the organ in man which has common outlet for urine and semen. There is difference between semen and sperm. Semen is a fluid. The plasma part of semen, a fluid part of semen, is a secretion of seminal vesicle, prostate gland and other glands. In this are suspended the sperms. By now they are mature and ready for ejaculation and fertilization. So, this much about the structure of male reproductive system. Now, this slide shows TS of testis, and as we know, in the testis we find tubules, seminiferous tubules, and there are thousands of them in one testis. In this diagram, you can see seminiferous tubules having outlines. You can see germ cells, Leydig cells, Sertoli cells, and each cell has different role to play. The germ cells, which can be called spermatogonia also, they are finally going to enter into meiosis, meiotic division, and will give rise to sperms. I am sure you know the cell division. You must have heard about mitosis and meiosis. Mitosis takes place in somatic cells and meiosis takes place in germ cells. And difference between the two divisions, mitosis results into cells with the same number of chromosomes, and meiosis will result into the cells with half the number of chromosomes. And that is why our germ cells, in this case spermatogonia, will undergo meiosis, the meiotic division, to give rise to cells which are haploid or half the number of chromosomes or only X, whereas normal cell is 2X. Also, you are aware of the fact, children, that our cell has 46 chromosomes, that is 23 pairs. You can also say 22 plus 1 pair, 22 autosomes pairs and 1 sex chromosome pairs. In case of man, it is XY. In case of female, it is XX. Going back to seminiferous tubule, these spermatogonia are arranged near the outer periphery of the seminiferous tubule, of course, towards the inside of the outer membrane. They undergo division, the meiotic division, and go on dividing till they form the sperm by meiotic division. So, the most immature will be towards the periphery and most mature will be towards the lumen, hence sperm will be in the lumen. The Sertoli cells which you are seeing within the seminiferous tubule, in between the germ cells or spermatogonia, these are having nutritive and supportive function. In between the seminiferous tubule, there are some spaces, you can say interstitial spaces, and there you find some cells which are secretory in nature, and we call them interstitial cells or Leydig cells, and they are source of male hormone androgens, or in particular testosterone. So, sperm is formed inside the seminiferous tubule and sex hormone is coming from interstitial spaces. You can see Leydig cell here in the interstitial space enlarged, and they are the only source of sex hormone in case of men. And because of this hormone, man looks man, or man has masculine characteristics like beard, like mustaches, like external genitalia, and this hormone is important for masculine features. Sertoli cells, which I discussed, that they are nutritive and supportive in nature and are present in seminiferous tubule, you can have a good view of Sertoli cells here. Coming to sperm, this is a slide showing sperm. Whole reproductive system is designed for formation of gamete, in this case male gamete, sperm, and it is formed by meiosis, so it is haploid. It has half the number of chromosomes, that is 23 in number, 22 autosomes and one sex chromosome, which in the case of man can be X or Y. So, try to appreciate the fact that this sperm or any sperm will have 22 autosomes and one sex chromosome, which will be either Y or X, because the total number of sperms produced, which are millions in number, 50% will be X carrying, 50% will be Y carrying. So, if Y carrying sperm fertilizes, it will be a boy, and if X carrying sperm fertilizes, it will be a girl, because female has both X's. That means sex of the child is decided by father and not by mother. Let's now see the structure of sperm. It has head, neck, middle piece and tail. In the head, you can see one pointed structure called acrosome, which lodges in such a way, so it has enzyme, and that enzyme helps in penetration of ova by this acrosome. In the middle piece, there are many mitochondria to provide energy in the form of ATP for this sperm to swim its way through male system and then through female system to fertilize the ovum. You can also see in the diagram one nice tail, and this tail is required to help in swimming. If a sperm is defective, not having a tail, cannot swim properly, cannot fertilize. If tail is bifurcated, then also it is defective sperm. So, if a sperm is defective, the probability of fertilization reduces. So, a sperm is a male gamete with half the number of chromosomes, or haploid, or X number of chromosomes, which is now ready to fertilize the ovum. It will travel all the way from male system, from testes to epididymis to vas deferens to urethra to penis, then the vagina of female, uterus of female, oviduct of female, and reach all the way near ovary to fertilize the ovum. And that is why it has a nice tail. With this, we come to the end of male reproductive system. You have understood about the testes, the epididymis, the vas deferens, other accessory sex organs, and also structure of seminiferous tubules, and how sperm is formed. With this, we come to the end of this topic. Thank you.